those with an older Tesla, mine is about 3 years old, and with MCU-1, might have experienced this problem that things are getting a little bit slower on the screen. It takes a lot longer until the map refreshes, navigation takes longer to calculate, all sorts of issues. So one solution could be to get MCU-2. I will do that, by the way. I'll get one in about a month's time. Yeah, today I had a ranger here to replace one of these door handles, and he gave me the following tip. Why don't you do a factory reset? So in this clip, I'll show you how this works, what the different screens are. It takes about 10 to 15 minutes, but this clip will be a little bit shorter. So if you like this channel, please subscribe to it. I would appreciate that. And now just enjoy the next few images of my factory reset. The screens are sometimes in German, but that doesn't really matter, I think. You get the idea. Okay, bye-bye, thanks for watching. One thing that shows that the chip in the MCU has reached its capacity is the handbook. In theory, the handbook should be visible, but in my case, only the headlines, only the titles are shown, but the rest of the handbook is empty. The contents is not shown. I've called the service center numerous times and they said, well, I should get the MCU-2. That's of course possible, but it costs money. And the car was delivered with a functioning handbook, so it should be working. That's at least my opinion, and I've also made a video on that. So the service center looked at the issue but could not find a real solution. On the other hand, this very kind ranger who was here today pointed out that my car was now 3 years old and that all data is stored. All the navigation data is being stored, the Spotify data, the personal profile, everything gets stored on the chip. So the chip just gets clogged up, filled with data, and therefore the performance is very sluggish. So what you do is a factory reset. You press service, then whatever it says here, factory reset. You have to put in your Tesla account. And therefore, once you confirm that your data will be erased, like your personal profile in the car, the reset procedure will start. After waiting a little while, the systems will slowly come to life again, but in a strange way. You see the screen here at the steering wheel has sort of this milky appearance. Then the Tesla sign shows up first on the small screen, but not on the big screen. Then it goes off again. It'll come back on. Well, I won't run the camera all the time and shorten this clip a little bit, but you have a little bit of a light show. And interestingly, even though I am in Europe, when this screen comes up again, it will be in English. And you see the sign in miles. The clock shows 5 a.m., even though we're in the afternoon here. And the recuperation has no information at all. Then all of a sudden, we get this beautiful light show. I guess the system is just testing the color LEDs of the main screen. Turns off again. So after a while, we see the Tesla sign again on the steering wheel screen and also on the main screen. And the display is still set in miles, US mode. But all of a sudden it switches to German. And the car remembers that I had the wipers on, so the wipers start working. And then the car tells you that the reset has been finished. The ventilation starts to work as well. But interestingly, the map is displayed in night mode, although it's light outside. Well, to fix that, I just got out of the car, went back in again, and then the map was displayed in daylight mode. You see now the regen is also shown, the regen limitations, the outside temperature is shown, but the clock is still wrong. Those things have to be set manually, the same as the user profile, the seat positions, etc. And now I'll test two things. The first one is, how fast is the navigation now? How fast will it show me the new route? So I put in Zurich. First the system asked me whether I agree to pass on data to Tesla, which I do. And then the navigation system very quickly shows me the route from here to Zurich. And this is really done a lot faster than before I did the factory reset. The second test concerns the map, and you can see that I can move the image around quite easily. It's not zipping fast, but a lot faster than before the factory reset. Reasonably fast, really nice. And the big sensation is the handbook. You know, it was gone before, and now I press the different items, and lo and behold, everything is displayed. It doesn't come up lightning fast, but it comes up reasonably fast. Everything is there again as it was before when I first bought the car. So, in a summary, I would say you do not need to buy an MCU-2 if you just want to get rid of the sluggishness in the display. While there may be other good reasons to buy an MCU-2, and this factory reset might also work if an MCU-2 gets slow. Anyway, thanks a lot for watching. Thanks for supporting this channel if you like it, and see you around. Bye-bye.